Tambling, you say here in your book that it's only a matter of time before the strangers from the skies come to know us better. Now, are you suggesting some kind of invasion from outer space?
This is quite possible. I don't think in the sense that we would think of it. But people coming, yes. I've researched quite deeply into this. My solution is that they come from everywhere in space. This galaxy, other galaxies, everywhere except Earth.
Now, why would they want to come to the Earth, the planet Earth? Because we're, as I said earlier, apparently a rather technologically backward nation or Earth or planet compared with where they've come from.
Yes, I haven't an answer, a direct answer to this.
I guess that was when I heard it. It was some kind of zipping sound. And when I turned all around, in this area out here, about 40, 50 feet out there, it was some kind of craft, you know. It looked like it's going to come right onto the ground. But it came on down and hovered about a foot and a half or 2 feet off of the ground. And we didn't know what to do, you know. And then before we had time to really do anything, it seemed like an opening appeared. Toward the end, it was, you know, and the blue light, it had blue flashing lights as it was, you know, approaching the ground, but then they went out. And when the opening appeared, some source of light came from the inside. It was just almost blind. I kind of thought it was people at first, but, you know, off like that. But of course, when they appeared there in front of me, it was the most shock I've ever had in my life.
I don't know. I think that they know more of what's going on down here on this earth than we think. And I don't know. They might have been, you might say, looking for somebody that could, you might say, hold up under the strain and convince people that there is another world and there's some kind of life on it.
You're not suggesting that some of those might be fakes?
I think this is always a question. You know, we people here aren't always honest, and I think there's always the opportunist. I don't want them to believe in flying saucers or disbelieve in flying saucers. I want them to get out and look and see them.
All right, well, we'll go and look and see and think, and thank you very much, Mr. Tambling.